stemming from women, honoring women who are pioneers in their fields and working to inspire the next generation of great scientists.
And that inspiration can come in many forms, including a science rap.
Forest fires burning in the west, pinions. The weather started to change, quake like a ninja, rushing like a hurricane so fast. Keep in Taurus City Dam, knowledge is a drug I would teach a body burn. Keepers of composure when threatened by a tree, magnetized by the job of preparing our youth. Innovation is the answer, yo, we evolve it. It's how change and ways work together to solve it.
Oh, this is so great. That was Dr. Tracy Panera. Getting creative when talking about science to a group of students interested in STEM fields. She's a scientist at Moat Marine Laboratory and Aquarium, and she joins us from Gainesville, Florida. All right, Dr. Panera, that was phenomenal.
Can you give us a second verse?
Yeah, we love the second verse.
That is so embarrassing.
Not at all. Good. It was so fantastic. Now, we need the lyrics. You got to fill us in on them. But and also, you said, I mean, this is the moment you've been working your whole life for. So why?
So, well, my whole life has been full of obstacles, but the one thing that I was always really good at was taking scientific information and putting it in an art form that's easily accessible to my classmates or the public. So the first time I ever did that was for a public or a presentation for school. And my professor was new at the time. And I, you know, finished my regular presentation and I took off my blazer and I had my crop top on. I put a bandana on and I rapped Wu-Tang about activated carbon. And that's
so what is your main message, you know, with all these raps and all these presentations?
Well, I'm always trying to get people more involved in science and make science and learning fun and show people that, you know, being a scientist or an engineer doesn't necessarily mean that you have to sit behind a computer or in a laboratory. There's so many different things that you can do, and it's actually fun. I mean, the discovery of science and the discovery of how the world works is exciting enough.
Yeah.
But when you go and you make it fun too, then, you know, how can you say no?
Right.
We're with you.
Yeah, 100%. Now, you know, your Twitter handle, your tag on Instagram is Inspector Planet. So tell us about Inspector Planet and about your comic book.
Oh, yeah, that too. So Inspector Planet is really a mission to get people involved in science and in environment. I really want to inspire passion for the environment because we protect what we love, right? So Inspector Planet is basically, it's just an idea to get people as a team more involved, kind of like a chain reaction or a contagious behavior change.
Yeah.
To environmental and sustainability, really, and about the comic, that's just another art form to get people involved in science.
Yeah, express yourself.
And honestly, and the comic kind of it kind of mirrors my life. It's with another girl, and it mirrors hers too. But so basically, a scientist goes out and finds environmental problems and solves them through principles of science, which,
awesome.
You know, going through school, you think it's going to be so easy to just go out and find something and solve it. But as we know, things are a little bit tougher, and especially mm-hmm. with this past Florida red tide bloom, things got, it's a native species.
Yeah.
So, you know, solving the problem isn't as direct as you would think.
Yeah. So, you know, what got you inspired? It seems that there's always one event or one thing that inspired, you know, people to go into their field. What was it for you?
For me, there were two pinnacle moments in my life. The first one is when I learned about Love Canal, a hazardous waste dump site where industries were dumping toxic waste that was getting into the soil and the groundwater, and people were building houses and schools, and there were birth defects and cancer clusters. And I realized how our impacts impact the environment and then come back to affect our health. And the second thing is when I found out that unsafe drinking water was one of the five world's leading killers. And when I learned about that, it just, you know, there was a fire ignited. I needed to do something. And that's when you really find your passion, when you want to do something, whether you're paid for it or not. It just, you know, it's a call to action, really.
Yeah, it is. Tracy Panera, Dr. Tracy Panera,
yes.
Thank you so much. Every time we talk to you about science, you know, you bring this kind of enthusiasm that we saw you bring
it's
to
infectious.
Those girls. Yes, talking about STEM. So thank you for inspiring us and all who's watching.
That's right. And we'll continue STEMming from Women next hour on AMHQ, talking to Angela Ashmore, who is